Hey designer, Alex here, welcome to the channel, and in today's video we are going to do something a little bit different than usual. In this video I'm going to show you some awesome resources for designers that I have found online. This is a new video series. If you like it, please let me know down in the comments below, and I will try to create these videos from time to time to give you guys some great resources I have found online. So without any further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so the resource number one is Blush, and Blush are these great illustrations, and you can see from here these illustrations are from various different designers, and they have created this amazing pack. So if you click right here, go to the plans to see the pricing, you can see that the Doodler plan is completely free. You get unlimited downloads, medium resolution PNGs, which basically means you cannot edit these illustrations, they are what they are right here. But you can basically edit them online and create these illustrations right here on this website to fit the purpose you want them to be. So if I go back here to Blush once again, you can see if you scroll down all kinds of different illustrations. So basically how it works, you can choose your style, you can customize the art, so you can change, for example, the color of the skin, the color of the hair, you can change these glasses and so on, and then you can save that design using the PNG I was talking about previously. So these are the artists who have created these illustrations, and if you hover over some of these, you can see the styles, and you have a lot of other artists as well. You can see how the builder looks like, and they also have Figma and Sketch plugins if you're using one of these two softwares. Nothing yet for Adobe XD, but once again, if you want, you can create these illustrations online and then you can download them as PNGs. You can see what other people are saying. You can see some of the different collections. So let's say I want to click on this one and explore how it looks like, and you can basically see how these illustrations look like. Of course, some of them are going to be locked because you will have to upgrade, and that's basically how they're making their money. Just because you have to support all of these artists, because as you can see, these illustrations are just amazing. You are getting some of these for free, of course, but if you want to use all of them, then you will have to upgrade to that premium plan. So I encourage you, if you're after some of this stuff, you can then go ahead and explore some of these free options. You can upgrade these characters, you can create them to look however you want. As you saw, there are a lot of different illustration styles right here, so you can explore some of them. If you like them, then I will really encourage you to purchase the premium plan if you really need this sort of thing. Next, we have Font Ninja, and this is basically an awesome tool if you want to identify what some websites are using. And I see this a lot in some online groups and Facebook groups especially. A lot of the designers are asking which fonts do these people use, for example, for web design and app design and so on. With this tool, you can simply upload the link and you can attach the link, and it will scan the fonts on that page and it will show you what the font is and where you can get the font as well. Is it free or is it paid font? So that's just some great solution for all of you guys who just want to learn which fonts do these other designers were using and these other websites. Of course, if you want to access the full library and full capabilities, you can pay $29 a year if this is something that you're going to use a lot of the time. But if not, you can simply use their free plan and simply explore some of these fonts. For example, if you want to scan from time to time and learn which some of these fonts are. Next one is Red Background Images, and how this is working, basically you can choose from a variety of these different shapes. So as you can see, we have these triangles, we have particles, we have CSS gradient, we have gradient topography, which is basically this one, and finally we have simple just flat color backgrounds. So how all of this works is basically you can click right here and you can change these colors. So you can click here, let's say. And if I click right here, it will take me right here to this triangleify.io. And I will leave the links to all of these resources down in the description below. But this is just if you want to further modify these triangles, for example, then you can go to this additional website. And here you can choose from gradient, you can choose from sparkle, shadows, and so on. You can choose pattern identity, triangle variance, so you can change all of this stuff, cell size, so how big the triangles are. You can hit randomize and get all of these additional triangles. You can choose for whichever color combination you want, for example this one, and you also have custom, so you can click right here and you can click to edit these colors to adapt them to the colors you want. You can change the height, so let's say 1920 by 1080, and you get the full HD from here. And that's basically it. That's how all of this works, and you can basically simply hit export right here to export it to your desktop, or you can do the same for all of these additional ones. So here we have these particles. If I click right here, you can go to particles.js and basically do the same thing, and you can quickly change the colors right here at the top if you want to use this one. So basically, if you want some great backgrounds for your desktop or for website work, app design work and so on, then I really recommend this tool. Just get in here and adapt all of these things which I showed you, then download them as PNG or JPEG and simply use them in your designs. Next resource is upload image or remove.bg, and this is basically never ever ever going to replace manual work and using something like Photoshop to precisely cut out the image from the background, but it's going to give you a sort of a leg up if you want, and it's going to reduce you a lot of that work, and it's going to improve your speed when you're working on these sort of things if you don't have the budget to outsource, for example, a beginner designer to do these things for you. So here is how it works. You can simply click right here to upload an image. You can drag and drop a file, you can paste the image or use the URL to use the image from the internet, and they have provided some of these images here, so let's check them out and see how it works. So once you click on the image, it's going to show you the original. It's going to show you it with the removed background. And because this is their example, it's obviously going to work well, because you can see that they have used in the original image this really nice light source. So I really think that they have used a flash, and this is a professionally done image. So let's say that photographer was standing in front of the model, somebody else was using flash, and then you can see how this model stands out right in front of this background, which makes it a lot easier for this online tool to work its magic. You can also do this in Photoshop, but as I said, if you want to improve your speed just a little bit more and save a lot of time, you can do that here as well. You can see how a removed background works, and you can also edit some of these things right here if you want to further improve this result for yourself. So once again, if you don't have Photoshop, if you don't have time, if you don't have the budget to outsource this work to somebody else, then this tool perhaps can help you with your work. And final tool is this free mesh gradient, and it's from LS Store. So you can go to LS Store, they are selling these design products, they are selling mockups, they are selling illustrations, but this is just one of their free resources, and I think this resource is great for you guys. So here is how it looks like. You get all of these other file formats, so you get Sketch, Adobe Illustrator, EPS, JPEG and PNG, and this is how these gradients look like. You can simply download full pack from here, and these are just your gradients. So if you want to download some of these gradients just in JPEG, you can, for example, let's say this one, click on this one and it will open it in another browser window, and you can see it's 4000 by 3000 pixels, so it's extremely huge. So if you want to use it as a JPEG, you can do that from here, but if not, you can simply go to this page and simply use some of these links to download it in any of these file formats. Simply click download full pack, and I would really recommend you guys to use this, because as you know, gradients are all the rage these days, as well as 3D illustrations and 3D mockups. So that's basically it for this video. Let me know down in the comments below, do you like these sort of videos, if you want me to create more of them and to show you guys more of these great resources. Once again, some of them are free, as you saw, some of them are paid, but I always try to find resources which have at least free version for you guys to check out and explore for yourself if they are the right fit for you. So if you like this video, hit the like button. Make sure you subscribe because I upload new videos every single week on design, passive income techniques, motivation and more. So not to miss that, make sure you subscribe and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.